If you have a Bible tonight, turn to Revelations chapter 21. We finished up chapter 20 this morning in the morning service because it dealt with the white throne judgment. But now we're moving out of the judgment part, the tribulation part, into the heaven part. Amen? I like that, don't you? John writes in chapter 21, verse number 1, he says, "And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea." I like that, don't you? John said, "I saw a new heaven and a new earth." Amen? Now, I know we've got preachers today that are a lot smarter than I am that are saying that this earth here will never pass away, that God's just going to remake and redo this. But I'm not that smart yet, so I just believe this book, and this book says we'll get a new heaven and a new earth. Amen? Not a remake of the old one, but a brand new one. Brand new. Amen? When the Lord saved me, He made me brand new. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
You say, "Well, you don't look no different, preacher." Well, you're like Keith's song, "You're looking on the outside." If you could look on the inside, I'm a new man, amen? I'm a new creation in Christ. I'm not the old man, little sister. I'm a new man in Christ now, amen? The old man passed away when the new man was born. I've got a new body coming. I've got a new soul. I've got a new body. Got my name written down in heaven. Dora got a new husband the day the Lord saved me. I got a new wife the day the Lord saved her. Amen. All things are new in Christ Jesus. Amen. God don't remake the old, sister. He makes the brand new, don't He? Amen. Amen. I like that. I'm glad I'm new, ain't you? I've seen people and they'll stand up in them little AA meetings and say, "I'm an alcoholic. I'm a recovering alcoholic." Or, "I've been an alcoholic for X number of years." I want to tell you, Jesus Christ can make you new.
Amen.
Amen. He could set you free from the bondage of alcohol. He can make a new man out of you. I was a chain smoker when Jesus saved me. I don't think it's a sin to smoke now. So don't run out and tell everybody the preacher said it's a sin to smoke. I don't think it is. But I do know that I was a chain smoker and the Lord took that away from me like that. It didn't bother me. Less than an hour, and I've never had another one, and going on 26 years. I don't want them anymore. Why? He made a new man out of me, and I don't need them anymore. You can't be a big mouth preacher if you're coughing all the time, can you? Amen? That's why he took them away from me, because I hacked and coughed all the time. He gave me a new set of lungs when he took him away from me. Old brother preaching one day and he said, "I'll tell you something, drunkard." He said, "God can save you in the latter part of your life and give you a new heart, but you'll still have the same old liver." I like that, don't you? I say give your heart to Jesus young on. Don't you? "I saw a new heaven and a new earth," he said, "for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away and there were no more sea." Do you realize how much more land they would be on planet earth right now if you didn't have the oceans of the world?
Amen.
The oceans of the world take up 2/3 of the land mass of the globe. You talk about dirt cheap property, it'd be everywhere. You could buy an acre of land for a song and sing it yourself. There'd be so much elbow room you might not see your neighbor for 20 years. I like that, don't you? Now I'm going to tell you, I'm a country boy and I like a little elbow room. I don't want to live in a housing complex so close that the painter can't get between the houses to paint the wall, do you? I don't like that. I like a little elbow room. When God makes the new heaven and the new earth, He said there'd be no more sea. So if there ain't no seed, then there's all kinds of land, ain't there? Amen. I like that, don't you? So he says in verse number 2, "And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband." Now he says here, not only did he see a new heaven and a new earth, but he sees the new city, New Jerusalem, coming down. Now they're fighting and fussified in Jerusalem right now. They fight over that city. It's been a battleground for 6,000 years.
Amen.
But there's a new one coming.
Amen.
And this God, they'll not fight over it. Well, No. When the new Jerusalem comes down, it's coming down the pearl from heaven. Amen. It'll be a beautiful city. We'll look at what the Bible says about that city further on in this chapter. We won't get there tonight, but we will in the coming weeks. Amen. He says, "I saw New Jerusalem coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband." That city's going to be decked out in all its splendor, just like a bride is adorned for her husband on the wedding day.
Amen.
Now you know, boys, that the wedding's all about the girls. Say amen right there.
Amen.
It's all about the girls, ain't it? Ask the man about his wedding, he'll tell you he had one.
Yep.
That's about it. The girls will tell you what everybody wore. What songs were sung, what the preacher said, how the weather was, what the temperature was, how many clouds were in the sky that day. They've got all that down pat, right? He says in verse 3, "And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and He will dwell with them, and they shall be His people, and God Himself shall be with them and be their God." He said the tabernacle of God, the dwelling place of God, that's what the tabernacle is coming down to this earth. Amen. Oh, praise the Lord. My God, that's enough right there to make a Baptist shout, ain't it? Amen. When the tabernacle of God comes down to this earth, I want to tell you right now, He tabernacles in me just a little bit now. Amen. And I like it, don't you? It stirs me up just a little bit. Amen. I like that, don't you? Your Bible says your body is a temple of the Holy Ghost, brother. He's in you already, ain't he? I might not be in the city, but the city's in me. Praise His holy name. He dwells in the hearts of His believers, don't He? Amen. He dwells in us. My God, you can't get a closer relationship than that. Jesus is in me, and bless God, I'm in Him. Praise the Lord. I'm glad of that, aren't you? The tabernacle of God's coming down to this planet. God's going to come down and tabernacle with His people. Oh my, I like that, don't you? Praise the Lord. He says, "And I heard a great voice out of heaven say, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men. He will dwell with them. They shall be His people, and God Himself shall be with them and be their God." Listen at verse 4. "And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes." How many tears is that? Amen. Is that all tears? Is that every tear? God will wipe every one of them away. Everything He does right, don't He? Amen. He's going to wipe the tears away. He said He'll wipe the tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things have passed away. Oh, I like that. Do you know what He's talking about there? The former things have passed away. He's talking about the sin curse.
Amen.
The sin curse, that which curses. You know what? I've sold a $50 bag of grass seed, and I'll bet you there ain't a handful of it come up. The ground's dry as powder. You know why that is? We are living under a sin curse on this planet. It's why my